Hello, hello everyone, and good morning again. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to every single programmer all over the world. So today the question I want us to answer is this. Is coding hard? Is it difficult to write code? Of course, this is going to help anybody who is about to start programming or who is thinking about being a programmer, or those who have already started a little bit and then kind of find it, like we did when we were starting, somehow exciting and at the same time confusing and at the same time kind of hopeless. Am I ever going to be good in this? Am I ever going to get paid for am I going to be to the point where I can be paid for the work I'm doing? Can I get that skill that it requires? And how long is that going to be to take me? It's so many questions just to answer, you know? So the point here now is, to me, to be able to answer you, is it hard? As in a professional software developer, is it hard coding? Yeah, unfortunately, like we say in Africa, nobody throws stones inside his own food. I have to admit that to me, it's the sweetest thing to do. But I shouldn't be selfish. I have to admit that at some point, across serious challenges, across serious problems, serious limitations in order to get where I am. And once across that, I don't see that anymore. I don't face such challenges anymore. Now it kind of flows. But still with that, I still have to be honest again and say, it is really, really hard to be a programmer. It is really, really hard to program. Because imagine, you might see most videos where these developers will be like, a life in a developer's life, a life in a software engineer's life, usually a short 10 minutes and other things. And at in some points in these videos, you can see, wow, what these guys do is kind of fun and cool, you know. But also in some other points, you might see that, wow, really? Every day you have to do that? Yes, unfortunately, I will focus on that part, that hard part. And I would add that these videos usually summarize 24 hours in 10 minutes or even less, 5 minutes sometimes. That is not reality. Reality is something else. For example, I would say, you can say, okay, when I wake up and as a programmer I do this, I wouldn't say when I wake up because I kind of assume I'm always awake. Because as a software developer, I'm always busy. My mind is always busy. So many times, I keep on dreaming of code. I keep on dreaming of solutions. The mind is never at rest, basically. If you are really, really deep, focused, programming every single day, you leave that. You understand what I'm talking about. So, basically, we don't sleep much. And the time required for you to sit down and be able to produce something cannot give you much time to sleep. So basically, you doze from time, if you are a free software developer, of course, you can doze from time to time or probably drop yourself in your bed and then have some naps and so on and so forth. But still, you can't really do like normal people do and lie down and fully sleep and other things. It's kind of, unless the job is not serious at hand. So you are just playing around. So I basically just keep on cycling in the thinking about code while sleeping, standing up and then going back to code and then thinking about it from morning till evening and so on and so forth and so on and so forth. And you might ask me, why is it like that? If I am a software developer and I work and I'm a company, I have to go from 9 to 5 of work, go from 8 to probably 5 in the evening and then come back, and why do I have to always do that? Yes, my case is a bit different. I'm a freelancer. I take care of myself. I build product for myself and so on. So it is important for me to achieve. It is important for me to finish. It is important for me to have a final product. It doesn't matter how long it takes. So I have to do it as soon as possible. So I can't give myself so much time to relax. So it is really, really important to note that. So maybe that's what makes it look hard. But even that software developer who goes from 9 to 5 and from 8 to 5 or whatever, at the moment you sit down, the company cannot allow you to just show up and then go back without any result. So at the moment you sit down, you have tasks to complete and it has to be completed. So basically, what we take a whole day to do, putting pressure on ourselves, you have to sit down in probably some few hours and have to achieve that. So basically, it is hard. It is just hard to be a software developer. And I won't even go into details about how the thinking process and the analysis, validation of ideas, studying user experience and users, how it is going to be to fit users, how to really come up with final features or functionalities, how to. It is just a whole lot. So basically, to me, a software developer is somebody who kind of has this open, wide brain that does almost everything at the same time, especially when you are a freelancer because you don't have anybody else to come and take care of you and answer this and that or bring part of the work and then you combine it yourself. You are the one man for the whole team. So, really, it is hard, but is that enough to discourage you from learning it, or why is it that still many people are flowing into computer science? Many people are still learning computer science. So, like I said in the beginning, personally, I do it for myself, and I ended up having this love for being a software developer. I just can't do away from code. Like, there's no day I don't write code. So it doesn't automatically signify that I'm very good in coding. No, but it's just like I personally love to do that, you know. And I kind of always have something to create, and so that makes me to always good. And it's not always that I'm paid to write the code. No, I'm not always paid for whatever code I write. No, but I just love to be in it and do it. So, and why is it that everybody is flowing into the computer science, and every day we still have people coming into it? And I believe the main reason might be, to me, computer science field, the computing field as we know it, is not still matured enough. So, those who know, it's not matured at all. So, we still need skills to improve. Even the giant companies we know today, like Facebook, Twitter, Google, whatever. These companies have gotten to a point where they realize, oh yes, we really need to start thinking of futuristic solutions for whatever computing system we have. So they are the people mostly who are the engines boosting and motivating schools and other places to make sure more people come into play in order to have more brains to think of solutions in order to increase our computing system or improve it. So that's my opinion, you know. There are many other reasons around apart from people thinking they are going to get jobs, get money, live fine, or be called a software developer, so on and so forth. Or be like me, people who want to build something and they don't have money to pay somebody to do so. They have to learn and then kind of come and do it themselves. So there are so many reasons, but one thing is sure, after all, you know, the impact of computing in our world is so huge to the extent that it is almost everywhere and you can't do away from it. And it is going to be cool, you know, to have an idea of how those things work. Either we like it or not, at some point it will undertake everything and it will cover up everything in our lives and we still have to deal with it. So this is the time to start learning how that goes, how that works, and be part of the whole flow, right? So, I hope that answered your question if you were thinking of such question. And if not, probably add up another question on top for me under your comments, in the comments section, and I'll try to answer. Or if you have an addition to do to add to these points I've raised, kindly add it down and other people will come and read it. So please, this is the time to probably like the video and subscribe to the channel so that we continue to discuss such subjects from time to time. And see you in the next video. Thank you so much. I am Zubuli.